Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Amateur Vintage Electronics. Today I'm going to do something I've been wanting to do for a long, long time. Now I have this Macintosh SE, and it's an earlier version which is only capable of having 800K floppy disk drives. Later there was the version with the FDHD, which means floppy drive high density. And this version then can read 1.4 megabyte floppy disks. And I finally got my hands on the ROM and the SWIM chips I'm going to need to upgrade this Macintosh SE to a high density floppy drive. Now, I will briefly show you what you need for that, and then we're going to open her up and do the upgrade. So basically, in order to do the upgrade, you need, as explained, the corresponding chips. So we have the high ROM, the low ROM, and the SWIM chip capable of reading the high density floppy drive. And then, of course, we will need a high density floppy drive, which I took out of a Macintosh SE30. Now, as you see, I have already removed the back case. And what we are going to do first is discharging the CRT as a precautionary measure. You should always do that and never forget that when working on the insides of a Macintosh. So as you see, I've loosened up the ground wire of the CRT screen, and I'm attaching a cable which is attached to a screwdriver. And I am going to go beneath the anode cap here. Try to touch it not too much, because I do not want electricity going through my body. It's a bit tricky of getting below the anode cap sometimes, but what can you do? You need to try it until it works. And once you get below, the idea is to touch the little metal pins that are down there in order to release the electricity. So you might even see a spark or hear a soft pop. Let's try it. Okay, there was nothing. Still keep touching the pins. So electricity is being released, because these CRT monitors, they safely store electricity, and this high voltage sign is actually very true. So you could electrocute yourself. Now, once that's done, I will put this aside and I will remove the logic board. Now, in order to remove the logic board, we need to get below here to remove the main power cable that goes from the logic board to the analog board. And in order to reach it better, I will start removing the SCSI cable, which goes to my SCSI 2SD, as you can see. It's a bit cramped in here. Just remove the cable completely, and you can see here, maybe, I hope. So let me get in there and let me zoom in a bit. You see here, this is the power cable, so we need to get this cable out. And I'll do this by slowly pulling it, and that's about it. And then there is one more cable that goes to the logic board, which is the floppy drive cable. That's also below here. And I've just removed it. Now, as you see, I've turned the Mac around. You can now remove the shield, because we won't need that. And then we slowly pull up the logic board just a tiny bit, so it unhooks here. And then you need to be careful because there is one more cable which connects the speaker. And I'll try to show you like that, hope you can see it. So you just disconnect the speaker cable and logic board removed. Besides upgrading the chip, we obviously also need to replace the floppy drive. So I will quickly loosen up these four screws here. Okay, once that's done, you can just turn it sideways so you can see better. Let's get rid of the screws. You can just pull out the drive carriage. There we go. Now we have arrived at the most critical part, which is replacing the chips. Now, how do I know how to do this? There is the official service source, which was provided by Apple back in the days, I think, to third-party repair companies. I will briefly show you a screen recording of this manual. You will see exactly which chips you need to change to perform the upgrade. They will tell you exactly which number the chips have. And here again to show you. So we will replace the high ROM, the low ROM, and the IVM chip with the new high ROM, low ROM, and the SWIM chip from the high density floppy drive. Now, this is a very delicate process because I don't know if these new chips will work because I got them from an old broken Mac SE board, and I don't want to ruin my perfectly fine working chips, so I will use two plastic pliers to very carefully try to remove these chips. And we have them removed. So as per instructions, I will now insert the high ROM. Just see if every pin sits. The low ROM. And the SWIM chip. Done! Let's get to the floppy drive. So the floppy drive is the easier exercise here. We'll take the high density floppy drive, I'll insert the floppy cable, and then we're gonna move it into the cage. Let's see. Perfect. And then we need to find the correct spot for it. And I think that should be it. And now that it sits, I will just put these four screws back. Done! So now we'll insert the logic board again, close the case, and then we're gonna try if this thing works. So, moment of truth. I will admit I'm a bit nervous. There is a bong, which is good. It's booting up. So that indicates to me that the ROM chips are working. And we'll test the floppy drive by using a 800K disk. It's 2DD, you can also recognize it because there is no secondary hole. And then we have this HD floppy disk, two holes, HD. So, yeah. Well, I'm glad that the system is booting up and the ROM chips seem to work fine. So the chips are not fried, which is very, very good. Now, it could be, of course, that the floppy drive itself is not working. Okay, it did recognize the 800K disk, so I will erase it and see what the floppy drive does. Okay, it allows me to use the 800K format. The disk failed. Okay, so the floppy drive obviously needs a bit of maintenance and cleaning, but let's see if it reads and recognizes the HD disk. I'll admit, I was expecting a bit more. Ah, yes, yes. So the Mac SE is recognizing 1.4 megabytes. So what I can say at this point is that the upgrade worked. We've successfully upgraded this Mac SE to a Mac SE FDHD. I will still have to clean the drive, see what's going on there, maybe use another 1.4 megabyte drive, but the upgrade itself worked fine. At this point, I want to thank Johan from Sweden, who was so kind to provide me with this set of chips, which is very super rare to find. And he pulled it off a broken SE board he had and sent it to me from up in Sweden. So thank you very much, Johan. You're great. I will hopefully be able to repay you in any other way. And yeah, that's how you upgrade a Macintosh SE to a high density floppy drive. Take care and have a great day.